we turned it around one day after I list it from $1 into $100 plus shipping. Hello everybody, welcome back to Commonwealth Flipper. My name is Kevin and we're in the Commonwealth cabin and we have a ton of sales today, both low priced and high priced. And I think it's like a grand total of 20, 24 things, 25 things, something like that. And we're going to get them all shipped out. We're going to make a decent amount of money. But last weekend I had a chance to go to a bunch of garage sales with my wife and my daughter. I haven't put those videos out yet, but the very first one we came across was a church sale that we weren't expecting to hit. We were going to a community sale and we're glad we hit that one first because I think we'll make a whole video out of that one. It was so good. And then the community sale we went to, we had one particular spot that turned out to be a picker's paradise and everything else was pretty bad. But we did buy one other thing at a sale and it cost $1. And we turned it around one day after I list it from $1 into $100 plus shipping. So that's a really good profit off of a $1 item. And we'll let you take a look at that in just a second, but I'm gonna show you all the sales today. And I think only two inside of the eBay cave today and the rest were out here, which is a little different than usual. We've been selling a lot from inside. So I'm pretty happy we've been selling some things from out here too. So we can get things moving and get the new merchandise in and get it listed. So before I show you that $1 into a $100 item, let's show you what else sold first. Let's go. It just started raining and we have a metal roof here. So if you hear some rain, that's what it is. I don't know if you can hear that or not. Hey, if you watched, I think it was last Sunday's video. I get confused sometimes. We got this shirt. She was asking $3 a piece for these Hard Rock Cafe. I think one was a Planet Hollywood. And I think we ended up paying, I think I asked for $2 a piece. But I think what we ended up doing was 3 for $7. At any rate, this one sold for $25 plus shipping for this one right here. This old vintage Made in the USA Hard Rock. Nothing amazing, but you can come across these quite often, either at thrift store or garage sales, and they're usually good for $25 plus shipping. This one I picked up for, I think, $1. I'm pretty sure it was $1. Matter of fact, I just edited this video, so it'll be out in a week or so. And I thought it was brand new in a package, and I thought it was gonna go for like $20 plus shipping, but it wasn't. It was an open box, and things had been moved around. But I still listed it. I listed it $2 under what everybody else was asking because I have a feeling this would be a long tail item if I didn't. And it sold fairly quickly in about a week, $12 plus shipping. Pulled a ton of Nintendo DS games out of the bottom of my death pile just in time to list them for the great video game sale of 2020. And this was one of the worst games. It's Wall-E Nintendo DS, and I think it only went for like $5.50. I think I bundled up a bunch together and didn't put this one in with it, and I'm like, ah. So I ended up just selling it on its own, and you know, we'll make a couple bucks. All right, here's the Red Octane Explorer guitar from Xbox. It says Gibson right there, and even has the stickers on it. And this one sold for $60 plus shipping. This one might be going international through global shipping program through GSP. And it took a little while to sell. I put it out there for a decent price at $60 plus shipping. And I'm happy about that price. I'm happy we got that amount of money. It came from the garage sale stalker video, the one where I bought the She-Ra lunchbox, if you've been watching on Commonwealth Picker. So we didn't pay much. We bundled this stuff up. So we have no more than $5 into this. And more than likely, it's around like $3 on it. All right, I'm gonna grab the camera for just a second because I don't wanna pick up this next one. It's a little bit too heavy for me. So let's take a look at this. $1 at a garage sale. I walked up and remember, this is like 3 hours after the community sale started and we were finding nothing. Every yard sale we went to, nothing. Reagan found a few things that she could wear and that's about it. And I walked up and this was up, there was like two sections to this garage sale. There's a woman setting up on the porch and I walked up there and I saw that sewing machine. My wife and my daughter saw the dog sitting in the doorway and I saw the sewing machine. So I didn't even see the dog and they didn't even see the sewing machine. So different eyes find different things for sure. But this was, I asked them like, how much for the sewing machine? I didn't even really want to buy it because it's a pain in the butt. But if the price was right, I was going to buy it. And it wasn't in perfect condition either. And she said $1 and I'm like, I can't turn that one down. So let's take a look at that. All right, here is the sewing machine. You can see how it's kind of off color a little bit. I wiped it down. It's not perfectly clean, but I plugged it in. I tested it and it's running pretty smooth. It sounds really good. There's nothing with it. I don't think any attachments or anything,
But this is the kind you used to find in a school setting, I think.
This one's a model 5825C.
Bought it for a dollar, listed it, sold the next day for $100 plus shipping. I put it under its market value just simply because there was nothing that came with it. No attachments or anything like that. It did have this. Nothing in the compartment over here or anything. But it did have the foot pedal right here and everything seemed to be working okay. But the discoloration and a few things that I couldn't clean up perfectly. And I'm like, you know what? I paid a buck. I'm going to sell this thing quick and get it shipped out. Probably could have listed it for $120. And waited a few days and got it. We listed it for $100 and got it really quick. So it's a really nice quick turnaround and didn't take up much space for very long. All right, I'm going to move you over this way and show you another thing we picked up 2 weeks ago. You might be watching this sale here pretty quick. These are the Tim LaHaye books. And I missed a whole set of them the week before. And I can't believe I did that. But I picked them up this time and they were 50 cents a piece at a church sale. And I thought about waiting and completing the set, but I decided against that as well. I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to list these things. You definitely can make more if you complete the set. But they weren't in perfect condition. I put them out there for $13 plus shipping, $12.95 plus shipping, and they sold pretty quick. So $2 into $12.95 medium mail shipping. You know, we're going to make a little less than 10 bucks on them. All right, I'm going to take you to one more place real quick and show you one other thing that sold. And this is out of our new, it's not a new bin, but the plate is on it. So we're now going to use everything we put in there is going to have the Hawaii skew. And it's Legos, small Legos. That's a small one. Is this the right one? Yep, Exxon Cowboy. Bring it over here and show it to you. There it is right there. My wife put together a few Lego sets that I bought, paid 15 bucks for this whole box, and we ended up making, I think, $400. And this is to a set that was incomplete, and she decided to list it for $10 free shipping, and it sold.
This is a pair of Woman's Eric Seeds, and they're not a great shoe. I would not pick them up again. I paid a dollar for them, and they sold on, essentially, clearance for like $6.31 plus shipping, so... At least we made some money, but they took up some space for a long, long time. All right, here's an interesting one, and this should be from a sale either you just saw or you're going to see really, really quickly here. Pretty good little sale. I was fortunate enough to get there right as they opened, and it was on totally on the other side of town. It was probably 40 minutes from my house. It's actually over there by Patriot Picker. I got there before you. And this Intellivision flashback, I asked the lady, I'm like, do you have any video games? And she said no. And then I immediately saw some video games on the table, and then I saw this behind them right next to them. I was like, well, actually, you do have some video games. She was really nice. And I paid $5 for this one, I believe is what I paid. It might have been $3, but I think it was $5. Now, the only problem here is that it smells like smoke. Everything that I got there, and there were a couple things that I got, smelled like smoke. There's a couple that I aired out here on the front porch of the cabin, and it came out pretty well. But when you're dealing with cardboard... It doesn't come out really well. You can wipe the stuff down inside, but it's still going to stink. And then clothing, you can wash it. You can air it out. You can usually get it out of a lot of clothing with a little bit of effort. But it wasn't going to come out of this. So I listed it a little bit cheaper than everybody else's out there. And I put in there, hey, read the description. And one person bought it, and I immediately sent him a message and said, hey, I just want to make sure that you saw this was from a smoking home. And then they replied, and they're like, oh, yeah, I didn't see that. Sorry, I don't want it. And then somebody else bought it like 20 minutes later, because it was a good price, 50 bucks plus shipping on this. And they said, yeah, when I sent them the message, they said, yeah, we did see that. And I thought it was a good price, so they wanted to take a chance. By reading that message, it kind of was clear that it was a gift for his father, and his father smoked, so it wasn't going to be an issue. So if you ever have one of those smoky things, don't be afraid to sell it. You know, you might be afraid to stick it next to some things in your cabin that you might not want to smell like smoke. But don't be afraid to sell them and just put it in the description. And I would send a message to the person who bought it immediately after they bought it and see if you can get a response from them before you ship it out. All right, Keith is at it again. He bought some Tupperware stuff. You bought the mustard and ketchup, I think. I remember you buying from last week, and maybe the salt and peppers too. And he is picking up the Pickle Keeper. And this one, when you buy these, you got to make sure they have the inside part as well. And I usually pick them up for a buck, and they usually go for right around $10 to $12. This one was $10.95. plus shipping. And I ship them out first class. Put some bubble wrap around them, stick it in a poly bag, and ship it out. So Keith says, hello, Kevin. Janet liked the one I bought from you, so I'm buying this one for her. So you did buy one of these. God bless you and your family from Minnesota. And you know what we're going to do, Keith? I see that you bought one of these stickers as well. So I'm going to take one of these stickers, and I'm going to put it inside here, and I'm going to save the 55-cent stamp on there. So, Keith, thank you so much for your support of the channel, and thank you for supporting ReaganCommonwealthPicker.com as well. We appreciate it. Oh, and thank you, Janet. All right, Super Mario DS, I think $17.95. I didn't write this one down. I think free shipping. And this one came from a $100 buy that I made just a couple weeks ago that you're going to see really, really quick as well. And I bought a ton of video games, and this was in there. So I should probably keep track, see how much we're going to make of that. But I probably am not going to, because so much of it is going to go to the antique booth and be put in lots. And we're just going to kind of cherry pick the best games. And this one was definitely worth selling as a one-off at $17. So, because I haven't even gone through all those games. I have Bubba up there going through them now. Maybe we'll put that on the end of this video or maybe next video. I haven't sold a golf club head cover in a while. This one's nothing amazing. A Strata 3 wood. Sold for $9.41 plus shipping. We sometimes sell those Auster Kitchen Center blenders. And they're not just blenders. They're mixers. They're the whole thing. And sometimes I come up with different things like this. Sometimes I'll sell this top part. I can take it out. I don't really want to take it out. And sometimes I'll sell the whole thing. This sold for $11. So it'll definitely go first class. It's probably going to be really close to 4 ounces, but it'll probably end up going over when we put it in a little box. You wouldn't want to put this in a poly mailer because this is going to break right here. It's plastic, but it's also kind of old and fragile plastic. It's not really flexible. So I would definitely put this one in a box. Also, I haven't sold a remote in a while. This one sold for $9.61 free shipping, and it will also go out. This one will probably get under 4 ounces. And I am not afraid to put those in these mini poly mailers. I love these things, by the way, and they are really pretty darn cheap. Well worth your money. It definitely is worth your money if you're going to bubble wrap something and then stick it in a poly bag. This already has the bubble in it, and it's really cheap. All right, we went out to lunch today, and then my wife took the Homeschool Hustlers over to get a pair of shoes for Turner because he's worn them out. So after lunch, she went over to do that, and I didn't want to go sit over there and do all that. So I had a student who had emailed me, one of my students at the high school that I work at, and they're like, hey, I got these DS games. You want to buy them from me? And I said, sure. And I took a look at them, and I knew about what I'd get for them. I'm like, hey, give me a price, and I'll come over and grab them. And I did. I think we paid $110 for a 2DS, a Nintendo 2DS, and 7 games. But out of the 7 games, 6 of them were Pokemon games. So you might think, hey, that's a lot of money. But we'll make our money back on probably the DS and one of the games, and we'll already be in the profit. And the other 6 games will be profit. This one right here went for $30 free shipping. It's a Kirby Planet Robobot. My oldest son was actually driving me while they were over doing that. So I told him I was going to take a picture right there in the car and it would sell before we got home. Well, it sold about 10 minutes after we got home, but I was close.
Hey, really quick before we go inside, I want to show you this birdhouse that got sent to us by Tom. It's got an Alaska license plate on the top, and we're going to hang it up in the tree. Just like he asked here, he says, maybe you can hang it on your porch or in a tree. And he also found some pencils for the Homeschool Hustlers. Actually, this one's for Turner, obviously. He loves cars and loves Lightning McQueen. And since he's in his homeschool now, I'm sure we will find a great use for these. So thank you so much. We do appreciate it. And he says he watches the videos every day. And he picked up a Super Shooter for $1 on Friday. And he sold it for $40 overnight. Tom, thanks so much. We appreciate it. Hey, and I have one more thing really quick. This is like a great day for me in the Commonwealth Cabin because this is the last one of these that we've sold, and it is headed out of here. The Emoji Flirt is gone, and you'll see behind there's none left. So the North Carolina shelf just lost the Emoji Flirt, and that is awesome. I think these were $10 plus shipping. Paid $2.50, so we're not making much, but they're finally gone. All right, so let's head on into the eBay cave and see what's sold in there. Hey, really quickly, Jane, I want to say thank you. That Wall-E Nintendo DS game was also bought by a viewer. Came across your reselling channel tonight and love it. Love what you're doing with your kids, teaching them about business and money. Glad to see people like you creating content. So, Jane, thank you so much for the purchase. We do appreciate it, and we're sorry we missed you when we talked about that item. I do have a couple of Inaman going out today. This one's going out to Darren. He says, hey, Kevin, Greetings from the beautiful Black Hills of South Dakota. I have been there and they are beautiful for sure. I just celebrated my 1 year anniversary of reselling and thought I'd treat myself to an Enaman for the eBay cave. I guess that's what you call yours, the eBay cave. I really enjoy the videos from you and your family and I appreciate all the great info. Thank you and blessings to your family. My fun Commonwealth connection is that he started kindergarten at Rosemont Elementary in Virginia Beach. Darren, thanks so much. We do appreciate it. All right, here's the plainest of Jane Tommy Bahama shirts. Now, this has nothing on it. There's nothing neat on the back. It's just black, and it just has plain black buttons. But it is 100% silk, and that's why I picked it up. Sold for $12.81 plus shipping. All right, this one's going out to Leanne and Laura Lee. Huge fans and watch all your shows. Love how you're a teacher to us and to your students. Started reselling in February. Just made top seller. We've even had our 17-year-old daughter chipping in without grumbling. Would love an autograph. Thanks again for all your tutelage. Terry, Leanne, and Laura Lee. So Terry and Leanne, my guess is mom and dad here, and Laura Lee is your 17-year-old daughter. That's awesome. Thanks so much, and I'm glad your daughter's helping out. You know, I have my 17-year-old boy up there, and he's been helping out a lot as well. Thanks so much, and hopefully he gets things moving for you. All right, I have a vintage Levi's jacket, and, you know, it's hard to believe I can't remember where something came from, but I just can't for the life of me remember this one, where I got it from. But it was at the bottom of a death pile for a while. I do remember pulling it out and listing it, so it's probably been at least a year since I bought this one. And I probably bought it in the summertime and put it in that death pile and forgot about it, but it's the kind with that little latch on back. And it took a while to sell. I don't think there's any staining problems on it. Maybe just a few at the bottom here, which took down the price a little bit. And this one right here, corduroy at the top. And this one sold for $30 plus shipping and took quite a while to sell. More than I thought, even in the summertime, it took over a month to sell. These usually go pretty good. All right, last thing we have going out today. Actually, technically it's not. There's three more things that I just didn't even want to bother talking about in here, including my daughter's shattered iPod that we sold off. So, hi, my name is Ryan. I've been watching your show for a while now. I'm a reseller, and so is my dad. We have been doing it for a year and are getting ready to expand into my 30 by 40 shop. My eBay store name is Ryben-2738. My dad's is Tebin-3248. So, that is awesome. Thank you, Ryan, and thank you to your dad as well. And good luck with that moving to that 30 by 40 shop. That's a big space for sure. And you know, nature abhors a vacuum, so you'll fill that thing up really, really quickly. That's one of the things we learn in history and one of the things I teach all the time. So even historically and politically, nature abhors a vacuum. Somebody will fill the void, and us eBayers know that for sure. If there's a void somewhere in your eBay space, you'll go out and buy, because buying is the funnest thing for sure. It's probably the second funnest thing for me because I love selling. That's the good. I love hearing that cha-ching. So at any rate, I'm going to say goodbye from in here and hopefully you join us next time. We appreciate each and every one of you, but we're going to head back in there really quick and check something else out in the eBay cave. Maybe it's Reagan doing out some shipping. I think that's what we'll be showing you because Reagan has some stickers she has to ship out. So thanks again and we'll see you next time. All right, Bubba is going through my games that I bought, the $100 box, and I've already pulled out three games. Hi. That should make very close to the $100 back. So what have you found out of the rest of them so far? By the way, I pay them $10 an hour to do this, FYI.
These two GameCube games, they go for, this one goes for like $35, $40. I think this one goes for $30.
Yep, Animal Crossing. That's right, Turner, you told me about Animal Crossing, didn't you?
Yeah, for Nintendo Switch, Reagan wants one.
He knows one. That one. Kindly Keen, does he play it? No?
No.
Who plays it?
Nobody.
Nobody?
He just sees a lot of people play it.
All right. And so this pile over here is the Bubba and Turner go through to play pile. Is that what it is?
Yeah. They don't go from up.
This is the stuff. This is the stuff we're going to lot up over there. The not very good games, we'll probably put those in the booth. I guess your system is to go through them and then throw them over there like a frisbee, huh?
Yep.
And these are the good ones that are definitely worth listing on eBay. $10 or more, probably. And you got a bunch to go. A bunch of Guitar Hero games, too. We might lot those all up, what do you think?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Are those all, like, lotted games over there?
Yeah.
Put them together and lot.
I don't know how much they go for yet, but I'm just...
Right, but put them together and then we'll probably lot them up. This saves me a whole ton of work, and he'll make some money off of it. So, there you go. Thank you.